We are pleased to be joined by Mark Mottone, the 2015 New Jersey Teacher of the Year, a pre-K special education teacher at Wallace Elementary School. How are you doing?
Good.
We're about to see a video from the Classroom Close-Up Series done by our partners at the New Jersey Education Association. I met you in Atlantic City.
Yes.
The NJEA convention, right? That was great?
That's right. It was awesome.
It was great.
Had a great time.
Real quick, before we see this video, how great is it being Teacher of the Year?
It's awesome. You know, you're able to visit schools, educators. You get to see what's going on in different communities. Something that you're not going to get being in the classroom, you know, all the time, you know. So it's been really great, connecting educators with educators throughout the state, even across state lines. So
you're an ambassador for educators. I just made that up.
It sounds
true.
Good, but
it is true. You ready to see this video?
Let's do it.
Let's do it. I know you've seen it, I've seen it, but more importantly, you need to see it. This is Classroom Close-Up, seeing the Teacher of the Year. It's great stuff. Check it out.
Thursday, high five. Awesome job. All right.
Since 1995, Mark Mottone, a pre-K special education teacher, has devoted much of his time to doing what is best for his students.
Teasing Mr. Alligator, can't catch.
Selected as the 2014-2015 New Jersey State Teacher of the Year, Mark's dedication and passion is not only felt by his colleagues, but also by his students.
What letter makes it sound? J. Oh, you're so smart.
Autism, I find, is a very complicated disability. It's complicated because every child I've ever worked with have always need something individualized. Now, it's not a cookie cutter approach in how we teach it. And not just in the classroom, but even the needs inside a home environment are so different. It's really a clean slate, and you need to really build a foundation for that child so that that child can learn.
Ava was diagnosed as being on the autism spectrum when she was 2.5. We did 6 months of early intervention, and then she was transitioned into the ABA program, which Mark runs. So I was always comfortable with her being in special ed. I mean, obviously, it's everyone's dream for their child to be mainstreamed, and I feel, you know, under Mark's direction, she has been able to reach her potential. He's given us hope and help when we felt hopeless and helpless. I made a lot of dreams come true.
When you're a teacher, I think you bring some of that parenting in the classroom. I think there's more of an understanding, but there's also that understanding of what goes on in your child's education as well. My son was about 2 years old. We knew he was having speech delays. We had him evaluated for speech, and we found out he had a 9-month delay. And the next day, he ended up going into seizures right at dinner. He's on medication now. He's in a preschool classroom. He receives speech. So, you know, I just want to make sure in the end that he's happy. That's it. It's like any of the children that come in my class.
Took him from there. And where do you want to put him? You just want to swing him?
My goal for each child is that they are able to learn to their maximum potential. Because even at the preschool, you're building that foundation. If I've set low expectations for them, then everybody's going to set low expectations for them. Don't ignore them just because, well, they have a disability. They don't know how to say hi. We'll teach it to them. It doesn't make a difference because they deserve that. I don't like to use the word success. I like to use that we're on the right path.
Did you like that song?
Yeah.
How personal is all this for you?
Very. It's very personal. I think when we talk about what we go into our careers for, in education, we talk about passion. We talk about the love of learning. There is something else that you just can't describe. And it's getting children to learn when people thought it was either impossible or they've tried so many other interventions or settings or programs, and now their child's able to learn. So it's very personal. I put every ounce of what I could into my students because I think any student deserves that kind of attention.
I often think about the concept of empathy. Do you try to imagine what it might be like for these children and their parents?
You know, I don't walk in their parents' footsteps, but they've invited me into their homes. And I've been on the phone with them midnight. I've Skyped during, could be questions or meltdowns or sleeping disturbances that they need help with. I will never walk in their footsteps. The closest I have was with my son, but their life is very difficult.
Why? Describe what they're facing.
They're facing challenges that, you know, especially in the preschool level, when you have a parent coming into preschool, they don't know what's going on with their child. Their child may have just been diagnosed or not even have a diagnosis. They may just have characteristics of, but not diagnosed yet. And it's very scary for them. And you as an educator have to be very sensitive to their needs. You have to walk them through every step. And it's more than just teaching their kids. It's about really getting to know them and understanding their parents' needs as well as their child's needs. And how can they best feel that they can help their child? I've been in many, many homes where the parents just don't feel they can give enough to their child. And they don't have anybody to turn to. I mean, we know it's a fact, resources for children with autism or special needs is very expensive. And if I can give them the expertise that I have, then I'm going to do that. And if they need other resources, I'm going to hook them up with that. Sometimes you have to break down that red tape for a child, because in the end, that's who suffers.
How are you able to do all that and still do for your own family?
There's a balance. There's a balance. It's a hard balance.
Do you ever get so consumed by your own students that it's hard to keep the balance?
No. There are times that, you know, usually I put everything away until maybe my kids go to bed. And then I'll get on the email at 8 o'clock if I have to talk to a parent. If I have a meeting after school, you know, I get out at 3 o'clock. So it's that extension of outside your time. It's not just a job for me.
So someone says your job ends at 3, you say?
No, it doesn't.
When does it end?
It ends when I stop receiving emails and phone calls from parents. But it's not going to end that way. My parents know, and that's something you put down, there are a lot of needs. And sometimes I may be the only resource. But they know and they respect, you know, my family. You know, they're not going to, you know, impose on that. But I think it's how I can help that is by helping them after school or before school and bring them in for training and go home to train them. They're not going to need me as much anymore. They're going to take the lead.
And finally, the greatest reward you get out of your work is?
Watching a child learn. It's a moment that I'm going to tell you, you cannot describe it. It's a skill that you've been working on for months and months, and it's that moment it just clicks. And then they're able to demonstrate it at home. And it may be so small to us as educators because we look at the bigger picture, but for those parents and for that child, that was that stepping stone that's going to take them further than we ever knew.
It's no secret why Marc Morton is the 2014-15 New Jersey Teacher of the Year. Thank you very much. You honor us by your presence and, more importantly, by the work you do every day. Thank you.
Thank you.
We'll be right back right after this. Thanks, Marc.
The preceding program has been a production of the Caucus Educational Corporation, celebrating over 25 years of broadcast excellence, and 13 for WNET, NJTV, and WHYY. Funding for this edition of Caucus New Jersey has been provided by the New Jersey Education Association, Wells Fargo, QualCare Inc., Felician College, United Water, New Jersey Sharing Network, and by Cohn-Resnick. Transportation provided by Airbrook Limousine, serving the metropolitan New York, New Jersey area. Caucus New Jersey has been produced in partnership with TriStar Studios.